In the last year, allergic diseases have increased in all Western countries, and the cause of the increase would appear to be related to both environmental and changes in Western lifestyle. To explain this phenomenon, the microflora hypothesis has suggested that the use of antibiotics and the change in diet typical of industrialized countries have modified the intestinal microbiome and consequently in the mechanism of immunological tolerance. In fact, several studies have shown that gut microbiota is different in atopic subject and in non-atopic subject. In atopic subject, we have more clostridi. In non-atopic subject, we have more lactobacilli and bifidobacteri. A lot of recent studies have shown that oral administration of specific live probiotic strains as bifidobacteri and lactobacilli may have therapeutic implication in the treatment of allergic disease. About the mechanism of action, it seems to be related to their ability to modify dendritic cell function, inducing the proliferation of Treg cells as Th3 subset of T helper cell and interleukin 10 production, suppressing the network, the inflammatory network induced by allergen. About clinical studies in primary prevention, a recent meta-analysis showed that the use of probiotic supplementation during pregnancy and in the first month of life reduced the risk of atopic sensitization and decreased the IgE level in children. The decrease of the risk of atopies was greater only when probiotics was started during pregnancy and continued after birth. About atopic dermatitis treatment, several studies show that probiotics are effective in the treatment of this disease. On the other hand, other study shows that probiotics are effective only in a setting of IgE sensitized children. Evidence about the efficacy of probiotic in food allergy was mixed. A systematic review found that probiotic supplementation may reduce symptoms and improve long-term tolerance in infants with co-allergy. However, five randomized trials found no benefit in food allergic children. Probiotics seems to be more effective in children with IgE-mediated form of food allergy. About wheezing and asthma, recent meta-analysis of clinical trial find that probiotics are not able to reduce asthma or wheeze, but authors speculate that the lack of effect of probiotics in reducing the risk of asthma or wheeze may have been due to probiotic strain used in these trials. About rhinitis, there are few studies. In a double-blind placebo-controlled trial in patients with pollinosis of Japanese cedar, probiotics reduce significantly rhinorrhea, sneezing, and itching. In conclusion, the effectiveness of the use of probiotic in prevention and the treatment of allergic disease is still a matter of debate, because the studies have sometimes produced conflicting results. Nevertheless, some studies have confirmed the immunomodulatory activity of probiotics. However, the beneficial effect of probiotics are surely strain-specific.